Okay, it's Monday morning. It's about 7:30, that's a bit later than normal. So I've been to the gym, and now I'm just doing some work on the laptop, finishing a few edits in one of the vlogs. We've got an exciting day today. We are going to be talking to an ethical factory. We've got a few calls to make. We've got my mentor's going to be talking to me about 3 o'clock this afternoon. Mentors are a really good thing. So it's someone that's got a lot more life experience and been through a lot of things that you're trying to do, and they can just disseminate all this really good advice. They can tell you if you're on the right track or not on the right track. So it's been really good. If you want to do something that you don't really know what you're doing, I'd really suggest getting a mentor or finding someone that's 10 years or 20 years ahead of where you want to be, and asking for their advice, because it's so helpful. And obviously Google can help you, but it's so much help, that personal interaction is so nice. Okay, talk to you guys soon. Oh, before I go, these water sachets are what I've been drinking out of. So we don't, obviously there's hardly any water, running water is a bit, you don't drink that, it's really bad. So we have to drink out of these sachets. You just bite at the end, pick it up, and suck it. It's nice. Hey everyone, back in the tro-tro again. Guess whose birthday it is? Happy birthday to you. We're supposed to be at a meeting at 10:30, but the traffic is so bad outside that it's just like...
Hey, I'm just gonna jump and tell you what you said.
Yeah, traffic's well bad, so hopefully we're gonna make the meeting, but we're not sure. Fingers crossed.
Yeah.
So I finally made it through the traffic, and I'm about to meet the ethical factory. So I'm really excited. I just hope everything goes well. Me and Stephen are here, meeting with the ethical Apparel Africa. And we're looking at the bags and we're trying to just see if we can do some at the ethical factory. So this is Dorcas, this is Poonam, who we've been talking to, and it's been a wonderful meeting and very exciting stuff to come.
Okay, so just had the meeting with the ethical factory, the ethical Apparel Africa. It was really cool. They know so much stuff, and they were telling me about all the different types of fabric, and the fabrics that I'm using at the moment for the bags, they actually have a problem with running, and they have certain chemicals in them, because they're a slightly they're a slightly cheaper fabric compared to some of the others, but I just love them because of their print. They actually got some really, really cool prints. So we're gonna have to think about that, and we might have to redesign some of the prints and stuff. It was quite good, because although today we were meant to be seeing the workshop with the guy that who actually makes these bags, or had made them. But actually it turns out that he didn't make them at all himself. He just found other people to make them and then put his label on it. Now, although I don't obviously that's quite good, good businessman, he's actually now not returning any of my calls, and he's not really working with us. So it's kind of unfortunate, because I would like to have kept it going and been able to reach out to the people that were actually making the bags, and talk to them. But it does explain the inconsistency with the quality, because we had some mad different shapes and some different prints going on, but it's overall really good, and I'm still really proud of the first time that we did them and got them shipped over to Hong Kong, so it's still going positively. Now I'm actually filming off my phone because my camera's cut out battery. I left both my camera charger and another battery on the plane, so it's obviously not ideal. So I'm gonna try and trying to find one now. Fingers crossed that we actually get a charger and a new battery. Not ideal. And it's Stephen's birthday, so special, his favourite meal for a special boy, obviously. So going to tuck in. Dave, sorry I didn't get 6 CDs, but food love. I'm here with Rama. Like, she's one of our designers for the bags. We're just talking about like a new design at the moment.
And she's so shy.
She's very shy. But she knows a lot about the African print fabrics, and she's gonna explain in a moment exactly like what they mean and like just these two prints here. This is a really cool print here. Yeah. So they actually designed this bag, which is really, really cool. So just tell us about what the prints mean. And what they're called.
It's
okay. Just look at the tree over there.
Yeah, I'm
gonna upload
it anyway.
Yeah, I'm gonna count down from 5. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
This is
Subra. Subra, okay.
Yeah, Subra.
So what does Subra mean?
Subra can mean cry and life.
Cry and life.
Su means cry, and then Bra means life. So it's like a combination. And then African prints usually convey a message. Different types of prints convey different messages. Yeah, and I don't have a wide range here, so I can't.
Okay. And so what does this one mean?
This one is immigrant sutra, which means being too aggressive or
being too aggressive.
Being too aggressive doesn't get the fire turned on. Something like that. Yeah. So.
Yeah. Wow. So is that why like is that your favorite bag then?
No. Favorite print? No.
You have to show us your favorite print like next time. Like, a cool video.
Sure. I have like three or four.
Okay.
Yeah.
Nice. Thank you for sharing. And for facing the camera, Fizz.